Бойцы, которые в ответ на протянутую для приветствия руку атакуют своего оппонента, всегда были осуждаемы зрителями. И также их нередко в том же бою наказывала карма. Сегодня мы расскажем именно о таком случае. M1 Global. 28 февраля состоится турнир UFC Fight Night марта 2008 года. Голландия, переполненный зал Top Sport Center. Именно здесь и в этот день стартовал первый в истории командный чемпионат мира по смешанным единоборствам M1 Challenge. Сборная Голландии под предводительством Гегарда Мусаси в одну калитку разнесла сборную Германии. Зрители довольны, а на ринге теперь бьются бойцы сборной Франции и российского клуба Red Devil. Для нашей команды этот турнир начался очень неудачно. Первые три боя французы забрали в свою пользу. Несколько исправил ситуацию молодой Михаил Заяц, который одолел своего оппонента. И вот при счете 1-3 на ринг поднимаются тяжеловесы. От Франции выходит огромный перекачанный Мартин Салтысик. Россию представляет 19-летний Кирилл Сидельников, ученик и спарринг-партнер Федора Емельяненко, которому уже тогда прочили большое будущее в смешанных единоборствах. Мартин Салтысик из Франции. Originally from Poland, moved to France to pursue his professional fighting career. 1-0, weighing 264 pounds, facing Kirill Sedelnikov from Russia and Fedor Emelianenko's Red Devil fight team. 1-1 to start his professional MMA career. That one win by way of knockout, weighing 229 pounds. Sedelnikov, just 19 years old, Jimmy, and he is outweighed by Soltysik by 35 pounds.
Now, that's going to be a factor should this fight go the distance. If all the other criteria is the same, a fighter who weighs more than 33 pounds, more than his opponent, gets, or weighs, is outweighed by more than 33 pounds, gets the nod in the decision. So it could be a factor if this goes the distance.
Heavyweights, but you already figured that out. Soltysik in the black with the white trim.
Soltysik coming out like a fireball. Big right hands. I do not see this going the distance at all.
Sedelnikov in the all black.
Now, Soltysik doesn't seem to respect Sedelnikov's power at all. Walking forward with his hands down, not concerned about a counterpunch at all.
Sedelnikov is a big man at 229 pounds, and he looks very small compared to Soltysik.
Nice movement, though, from Sedelnikov. Good head movement. He's avoiding the big strikes.
Huge right hand by Soltysik, just flipping above the ear.
Just as I said that, he catches a big right hand.
Warning from our referee, Marco Brusa.
If Sedelnikov is smart, he's going to ride this out and take it into the later rounds. At 271 pounds, it's more likely the guy's going to gas carrying around that kind of weight. You're not going to win by trading strikes with a guy who outweighs you by that much.
And that's what Sedelnikov told us was his strategy in our fighters' meeting.
I think he's getting drawn too much into exchange early on in the fight, though. A little bit of that pride getting the better of him. He's standing and trading with a much, much bigger opponent. Now, you can see Soltysik does not have a traditional boxer stance. Tends to keep his hands down, not throwing very tight combinations. A lot of wingy punches.
This looks like boxing right now. Nothing on the ground as of yet, no kicks. Soltysik getting off of that right hand, but just missing the mark.
Well, Soltysik's throwing a lot of right hand leads. They're easy to see, so. So Sedelnikov is getting out of the way. He's seeing those punches in time. But if one lands, that's going to be it.
Soltysik, you're right, Jimmy, is so big. He doesn't have to throw a perfect right hand, or even a left for that matter, to cause serious damage.
You can see he throws kind of a clubbing left and right. And even when he blocks it slightly, it still moves him backwards.
Looping left hand by Soltysik. It's the big overhand right that Sedelnikov has to be leery of. They're not beautiful punches, but if they hit, all sorts of damage. Soltysik nearly throwing the knee.
Now, Soltysik breathing heavy already. Looks like he may be a little bit fatigued. It's hard carrying that much weight around the ring. Hands are very, very low.
Are you surprised it hasn't gone to the ground yet?
Not at all.
Oh, big right hand punch, and that's
it! And that is it. Soltysik is still stunned. It doesn't look like he knows where he is. He's looking right at us, blank eyes. Monster right hand by Sedelnikov. Amazing knockout. That is punching power, my friend.
This happening right in front of us. Soltysik looking at you and me, Jimmy, almost asking what happened. He's completely disoriented. Sedelnikov fought his fight. He was patient. He looked for the counterpunch, and he threw it.
Great stoppage by the referee. He was all over that knockout.
Indeed, Marco Brusa jumping on immediately, stopping that fight, a one-punch knockout. Safety first in mixed martial arts.
Looking at us now, Soltysik smiling. That right hand right on the chin dropped him. and he is clearly not able to defend himself. Great stoppage, great punch. And the head snapping as he hits the ground, that's a lot of weight to hit at once.
On the cheekbone, just below the left eye, that's a kill switch punch.
And that's the danger in a guy like Saltychek leaving his hands down and being that aggressive. Wasn't covering, didn't have his hands high enough, caught the overhand right.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's the official decision.
Winner by KO right here, plus 93.
Fedor's got to be very pleased with that. He threw the right hand like an Emelianenko. Very tight, overhand, beautiful right hand. And once again, Saltychek caught having that left hand down. Didn't have it high enough, tight enough, and he paid the price. Got a little over-aggressive, didn't have the right form.
Saltychek, such heavy hands, but his boxing just was not that good. Kept his hands in a bat position, open to be caught, and threw a really overhand clubbing right hand that never truly found its mark.
You know, the problem with a guy Saltychek's size, you don't realize it doesn't take much to knock you out. A shot on the chin is going to drop anyone. I thought he got overly confident, got a little too aggressive, and he paid the price.
Kirill Sedelnikov.